Today's lesson is going to be all about the angles of isosceles triangles, like that one. Remember, two sides are going to be congruent in any isosceles triangle. So those two are congruent. Also, the base angles are going to be opposite those two sides, and the vertex angle is going to be created with those two sides. We're going to be using two different theorems today. The first is the isosceles triangle theorem, which says that if a triangle is an isosceles triangle, then the base angles are congruent. So they will have the same measure. We'll also use the triangle sum theorem, which is the sum of the interior angles of the triangle will always equal 180 degrees. When we combine these two ideas, everything will just make sense. Let's say the vertex angle was 40 degrees. How could we determine the other two angles, those two base angles? Well, remember, the sum of the interior angles is equal to 180 degrees, and you write it like that, 40 plus x equals 180. Then you just do algebra. You simplify by combining like terms. X plus x is 2x. Then we solve by moving the 40s over there. 2x equals 140. We divide both sides by 2, and we finally get that x is equal to 70 degrees. And that really is the entire lesson. We'll do another example of it. But look, the x's are both 70. 70 plus 70 plus 40 is equal to 180. Let's try again. You'll see a question like this on a test. If one angle of an isosceles triangle measures 100 degrees, what is the measure of the other two angles? Now, they don't tell us if the 100 degrees is a vertex angle or the base angles. Could they be the base angles, 100 and 100? Well, that's more than 90 degrees. It would come out like that. This will not form a triangle. So it has to be the vertex angle. Now the problem looks just like what we did before. Those two base angles have to be the same, so make them both x's. Use the triangle sum theorem. Sum of the interior angles is equal to 180. Write down the sum. 100 plus x equals 180. Simplify the left side by combining those two x's. And now we solve. Start moving things around. Subtract 100 from both sides. 2x equals just 80. Divide both sides by 2. And finally, your x will equal 40 degrees. We can now replace those x's with 40s, and remember that 100 plus 40 plus 40 does equal 180. So remember, if they're asking you for the angles of an isosceles triangle, just remember the base angles are equal to each other, they can both be x, and the sum of the interior angles always equals 180 degrees.